Okay, here's voltage controlled oscillator 2. It's pretty much the same as voltage controlled oscillator 1 with a few minor differences I will point out to you. First of all, in one of our FM slots, we have LFO like we did in oscillator 1. But we also have sample and hold mixer or pedal, which is to say if you had an external pedal, you could be controlling the frequency of oscillator 2. I don't have one, so I won't demonstrate that. However, I do have a sample and hold mixer, which is what is the default if you don't have a pedal plugged in. And over here in the sample and hold mixer, it's not just sample and hold. Okay, we have the opportunity to use sample and hold like we do in oscillator 1 over here in the second slot. The sample and hold mixer is not sample and hold. It is an incredible modulation mixer. Sample and hold mixer just makes it sound like you're mixing how much sample and hold it's getting, and that's not at all what's going on. Okay, let's have a listen just right now. That's not sample and hold. What are we hearing? Well, remember how we set it to the noise generator so that the sample and hold in oscillator 1 would have a normal sample and hold? And that is to say, the sample and hold is taking voltage samples from a random noise wave and then holding the voltage amounts and applying it to the pitch. So we hear that with the sample and hold that exists in oscillator 2. And the speed at which it takes those samples is controlled by the LFO frequency. And since the noise waveform is random, if you take a sample of voltage somewhere on it, and then somewhere else, you're gonna get two different random things. Okay, that's how we normally use sample and hold these days. However, that's one way. There are a lot of different ways. You can feed any waveform to it, and it will sample each waveform and then give you a voltage that is the result of the shape of that waveform. However, when we're using the sample and hold mixer, what we're getting are these waveforms pure without the sample and hold function happening. See, this is where we can use an oscillator to modulate another oscillator. And see, you wouldn't necessarily know that just by this name, sample and hold mixer. You'd think it had something to do with sample and hold. Well, it does have something to do with sample and hold because you can create complex sample and hold waveforms too. But when we're talking about just frequency modulation in this instance, in any instance where it says sample and hold mixer or pedal, you're just getting whatever waveforms are fed into this thing. So then it's just kind of a modulation mixer. So let's listen. Right there, we have oscillator 2 being modulated by noise. And if I think it's a set noise. The noise waveform is being applied to the waveform of oscillator 2. And this is a great way to really liven up and thicken up a waveform. Obviously, it's a little overt right there, but we back it off, we're adding little random bumps to the waveform of oscillator 2. It does have a pitch effect there, so you have to be careful. You'd have to retune it. But we can apply the output of oscillator 2's square wave to this sawtooth wave that we're currently listening to. Unfortunately, in this instance, we're just getting a pitch change sort of functionality, but there are other things that you could be doing with that. Instead, let's try and hear what happens when we apply the sawtooth from VCO1. You get some really ring moddy sounds there. And then you could really mess with VCO1 and you could hear the differences. Thank you. you can get some really weird effects by doing that. Also the square wave. So I'm modulating the frequency of oscillator 1 as oscillator 1 is being used as an audio range modulator of oscillator 2. And obviously there is a wide region of exploration that could occur with that. Of course, pulse width is going to have an effect. And so is pulse width mod if we're using the square wave as the modulating source. Also, we could add in, since this is a mixer, the output from VCO2. That could make some modulation interesting output. Or use noise. Yeah, so obviously there's a lot of interesting things that can go on using the sample and hold mixer input. We didn't even show output lag. Let's see if we take oscillator 1 and switch it into low mode, and then we modulate oscillator 2 with it. That's right. Oscillator 1 becomes a low frequency oscillator that is applied to the pitch of the frequency of oscillator 2. So now we're using oscillator 1 as a low frequency oscillator. We can change its waveform by manipulating its frequency with modulation. Anyhow, so yeah, there's a lot that can be done with the sample and hold mixer. We can also modulate the oscillator 2 with both sample and hold and the sample and hold mixer. Let's have a listen to that. The noise that we're using to drive the sample and hold function is now being also applied to the pitch. And we can also bring in... So yeah, there's a lot that can be done modulation-wise. Again, the makers of the Odyssey, the originally ARP and now KORG, have created a device that really puts a lot into modulation. Okay, another great function of Oscillator 2 is sync. Now sync, as you undoubtedly know, sync is a situation where the oscillator, the voltage-controlled oscillator present in oscillator 2 is forced to restart its waveform every time that the oscillator in the first oscillator restarts it. So let's get these guys in tune to start off. There we go. Okay, so here we are using oscillator 2, and we switch on sync. Why there's no effect? And why is there no effect? Because those two frequencies are in tune. We really need to mess with the tuning of oscillator 2 to get interesting things happening in regard to the sync effect. So one of the great ways to do this is to apply the adsr to the frequency of oscillator 2. See, oscillator 1 sounds normal, and we can add in oscillator 2, or either have oscillator 1 and 2 playing at the same time or not. Of course, that's not the only way we can get the sync effect doing something interesting, although it is one of the most common ways that we most likely recognize. You can also use sample and hold to do it. So sample and hold is changing the frequency of oscillator 2, and oscillator 2, while this is being done to it, is still trying to restart its waveform each time that oscillator 1 restarts its waveform. So that's the cause of this interesting effect. What if you wanted a sound that wasn't all rhythmic like that? You could switch. Now we're kind of moving into a different region here, but I want to hear this sound in this context. If you switch off LFO trigger to keyboard trigger, now it will take the sample each time you play a note. So you can hear it's getting different voltages from the noise each time I play a key. So then when you're just playing, there's no rhythmic da-da-da-da-da-da-da effect controlled by the LFO. You're actually controlling the sample with each note that you play. And we could throw in some LFO if you wanted. Some really, really cool timbral variation there that this arrangement doesn't happen a lot in vintage analog synthesizers, or even, I mean, some of the modern analog synthesizers don't have functionality like this. It's kind of a really rare effect. It's one of those great moments where you can say, oh, wow, I'm listening to an ARP ODYSSEY because I hear that effect. And it's one of the few synthesizers that had that feature built in. So that is a basic exploration of oscillator 2.